Hello everyone, Alex here from warrantoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can automatically generate an API key whenever a user signs up to your Cognito user pool, and then use that API key to ensure that they are authenticated through API Gateway. So in the video description, you'll see a repo for all my previous Cognito videos. I highly suggest you clone that to follow along. However, you can start from scratch if you want. Here, I'm in the API keys folder, and we're going to start things off by making a new directory called Lambda. We will need a Lambda function. This will be automatically ran whenever the user signs up, and this will generate a new API key and attach it to that user using Cognito user attributes. So to get started, we're going to navigate into the Lambda folder. We're going to run npm init-y. This will initialize the project. If we make a new file called index.js, we can then import a few things from the AWS SDK. So first, we need to install that with npm install AWS SDK. And we're going to import API Gateway and Cognito Identity Service Provider. We're going to import these from AWS SDK, and we're going to want to create a few objects using these. So we're going to say const API equals new API Gateway. We have to pass in a region. This is the region where your API lives. Mine is US East 1. And then I'm going to create a Cognito object, which will be new Cognito Identity Service Provider. We have to pass in a region, and that also lives on the US East 1 for my use case. We're then going to create an asynchronous main function. This will have one parameter, which I'll call event, and we're going to console log whatever's inside the event so we can have a better understanding of what's happening. And for now, we're going to return an empty string. In order for Lambda to have access to this method, we have to use exports.handler equals main. Now we can save this. We can go to our package JSON. I'm now going to paste in a test script from a previous video. You can find a link to this in the video description so you can easily copy and paste it. If we save this and we run npm run test, we see our empty event object, which is the object that's right here in the test script. And then we also see an empty line, which is from returning an empty string right here. So everything seems to be working. We can go ahead and close package JSON, and we're going to want to create a method called generate API key. That's going to be an asynchronous method. And we're going to need one parameter, which will be the sub, which is the UUID for the Cognito user. And we're going to have this return a new promise with resolve and reject. We're then going to create a parameter object. Inside, we're going to set a name. We're going to use a string literal. We're going to say tutorial dash and then the sub. We're going to say generate distinct ID will be true. And this will automatically generate a random string for us. That way we don't have to use our own custom generation. We're going to say enabled is true. We're then going to have stage keys, which will be an array. There's going to be one object inside of here for now. This is going to say the REST API ID. And then also the stage name. So if we go over to API Gateway, if we look at the top here, we see this random string. This is actually the API ID for the API you're selecting. I'm going to go ahead and copy that, and I'm going to paste that in right here. And then the stage name, if we go over, we can see under resources, or actually under stages, we see dev. So this is the one stage I'm using. So I would enter dev. You'd enter whatever your stage name is there. So now that we have this, we can actually run a method against the API object. So api.generateAPIKey, we're going to pass in the parameters, and we're going to get a callback, which will have error and our results. And we're going to use that to simply resolve or reject depending on what happens. So if there's an error, we're going to reject using that error. Otherwise, we're going to resolve with the results. And so going down, we can now say return generateAPIKey, and we can pass in event.sub. So we actually want to get the sub for the user I have. So we go over here, I'm at my user, and we can copy the UUID right here. Going back to our code, if we go to our package JSON, we could paste this in to the object. So we'll say sub will be the string. If we save this, we can close it. And then if we save this, we can run npm run test. Okay, so I made a mistake. This is actually create API key. So if we save this, we can then run this right here. Also, notice a typo, we forgot an in and distinct. So now if we run this again, it seems like things worked. So if we expand our console, we see our sub, which is the UUID for our Cognito user. We then also see a few different things here. One thing that's important to note is the value. This is the actual API key. So if we go over to API Gateway, and if we go to API keys, we search tutorial, which is what our API key starts with, as defined right here under the name. We can then see our API key here. If we click on this and we show the API key, we see the same exact value right here. So now our goal is to actually update this onto a Cognito user attribute for this user. So if we go over to our user pools and we go to attributes, if we scroll down, We can see that I already created a custom API key attribute. However, to do it yourself, you just click on add another attribute, you type in API key, and you click on save. We're gonna make a new function called save API key. This will be an asynchronous function which will have our sub and our API key as parameters. We're going to await a new promise with resolve and reject. We're then going to create a parameters object. This will have user attributes inside of it. This will be an array which will have various objects. We're just going to have one here. The name property with a capital N will be custom colon API key. And then the value property will be the API key parameter. We're then going to want the username, which will be the sub. And we're going to want the user pool ID, which will be a string that we can find by going to general settings. And at the top of our Cognito dashboard, we see pool ID. We can copy that. We can paste it in right there, and that should work. We can now run cognito.admin update user attributes. We can pass in the params, and we get a callback with an error and the results. We can then say, if there's an error, we're going to reject with the error. Otherwise, we're going to resolve with the results. Going back, we can now say const API key equals await generate API key. We're using this destructuring because this returns an actual object, as we see here. I'm noticing that this is actually value. So it's going to be the value object, but we're going to rename it to API key. We're then going to return save API key. We're going to pass an event.sub and the API key itself. If we save this, we can then run npm run test. We see an empty object. That usually means everything went well. If we go back to our user and we refresh, we then see an API key that starts with 7p right here. We go back to our API keys and we search again. We then see our old API key, which we can actually delete. And then we see our new API key here, which has the same exact value. So at this stage, if we navigate to the React application, we can run npm run start to actually run the application. If we see here, we have fetch new number, and this simply just calls an API gateway endpoint and then returns a random number. So if we go back to our React application and we go to random number, we see that we're using a get session method, which I'll go over here in a moment, but we're getting back headers, which will be the JWT token used to authenticate the user. This is something that Cognito actually handles behind the scenes. We don't have to worry about it. We just have to understand this method here, which will be found in the video description. Get session will return a bunch of information that we need about the user. What we want to do is we want to gain access to the actual attributes for the API key. If we change this to user, we can call to log user, and here the headers object can be user.headers. So this should work exactly the same way, except we're actually going to console log the user and not just the headers. The user will be all this information resolved right here. If we fetch a new number, we see our users right here, and we see our custom plan, which is an attribute that we have on our user. However, we do not see the custom API key. So in order to fix this, we have to go over to app clients. I'll open this new tab. If we show details, we can scroll down to set read and write permissions, and we can set the API key to readable. We do not want the API key to be updated, so we're going to keep this blank. We're going to click on save the client settings. If we go back, we clear the console, we try fetching a new number. We now see custom API key is right there. So it's actually inside the user object. I'm going to go through and I'm going to control Z to get back to whenever we're just using the headers. If we go to our accounts file, we can see that we have our headers object right here. We want to actually gain access to the API key inside of this object. So whenever we're using the get session method to return this information, we can simply pass in the headers and know that it's going to work when it comes to the Cognito authentication as well as the API key. So the first thing we have to do is we add in the key, which would be x-API key. This is what API gateway expects. And we're going to use attributes index of custom colon API key. So if we save both of these files, we go back here, we can clear our console, we can fetch a new number, and we see the headers object now has x API key. So everything seems to be working so far. For testing purposes, if we go back to our accounts and we comment this line out, we're then going to require our endpoints to have an API key, and we're going to see how this doesn't work once we make that change. So API key required, we change this to true. We save it, and we deploy this API. After waiting a minute or two, if we try fetching a new number, we see that we get an error. If we go and we uncomment this line, and we save this, if we go back and we fetch a new number, we see that we still get an error. This is because we actually have to set up a usage plan on our API gateway. So if we go back to API Gateway, or you go down to Usage Plans, we can then create a new usage plan. The name will be Tutorial. I'm not going to enable end throttling at all. I'm not going to enable a quota because this is just for testing. If we click on Next, we can add an API stage. We're going to select Tutorial, which is the name of our API. We can then select the Development stage. We can click on the check mark. We can click on Next, and then we can click on Done. So now we have this here. Now what we need to do is we need to actually update the API key whenever it's created to be attached to this usage plan. So beforehand, API Gateway didn't know that this API key was allowed to use this API, but using usage plans, they now do. So if we go into VS Code, we can go back to our Lambda function. We're going to create a new function called addToPlan. This will be an asynchronous function with an API key. This is going to return a new promise with resolve and reject. We're going to create a parameters object. This is going to have a key ID, a key type, which will be API-key, and then a usage plan ID. So actually, we're not going to pass in the API key. We're going to pass in the key ID here. And this is actually meant to be an underscore. So the usage plan ID is going to be a string. We can get that from right here, where we're selected under our tutorial usage plan. We can copy the ID. We paste it in here. This should now work. So we're going to want to say API.createUsagePlanKey. We're going to pass in the parameters, and we're going to get a callback with error and results. We're going to say if there's an error, we're going to reject. Otherwise, we're going to resolve with the results. So now we're going to want to actually destructure the ID here. And we can say await add to plan. We can pass in the ID. Going back to VS Code, if we get rid of our actual React app and we go back into our Lambda function, we can run npm run test. So I'm getting an error because I forgot to capitalize the I in key ID. So if we save that, this should now work. All right, it seems to have worked. So if we go to this new API key, we can see this starts with a B5. If we go back to our APIs and we select the tutorial API, we can then go to usage plans. We can select tutorial. We can go to API keys and we see our API key name right here. So this seems to have worked here. So now if we go to our resources, we go to our GET request. We see that our API key required is still true. If we then go back here and we actually run the application, we can then try fetching a new number. And we see that we have our X API key attribute here. And then we see our random number is actually being returned. And if we go back into our random number file, into our accounts.js file, and we comment this line out, so we're not getting the API key. If we go back here and we try again, we see we get an error. So everything should be working now whenever we're providing both the JWT token from Cognito, as well as the API key, which we dynamically set up. However, there's one thing left to do, and that is to set up the Lambda function to automatically run whenever a Cognito user is created. So if we go back, we can undo this so this works. If we go into our index file, we're actually going to get information passed into this event parameter from Cognito and not from our own test script. One thing that's important is that we can save the API key. We're going to still do that. However, we're going to want to return event. Another thing we want to do is know where we get the event. We want to say if event.trigger is exactly equal to this, the post confirmation confirm signup. This is after they've actually confirmed their email. And so we don't want to generate API keys for a user before their email is confirmed, just because there's no need. So if we save this, also this is, should be trigger source. So now if we save this, we can actually copy this code. We're going to go into Lambda, open it in a new tab. We're going to create a function. This one is going to be called create API key. And we're actually going to need to go into IAM and actually configure some permissions for this. If we go into policies, we can create a policy. This service will be API Gateway. We're looking for the right. We want to select post and then under resources. So if we click on add ARN, we can set the region to US East 1 and the API Gateway resource path. We want this to be /API keys. Click on add. We can review the policy. We're going to call this tutorial add API keys. We can create the policy. And now we want to create a new policy. If we go back to API Gateway, we can go to write. We want post still. If we go to resources, we can add an ARN. The region will be US East 1. And we want /usageplans /. Want to go to our API gateway. Want to get the ID for the usage plan. So we go to the tutorial usage plan, we copy this ID, and then /keys. We can click on add. We can review the policy. We'll call this tutorial add API key to usage plan. We can create the policy. And now we need to create a third policy. We're going to go to Cognito. We're going to select Cognito user pools. We're going to click on the right dropdown. I want to scroll down to admin update user attributes. Under resources, we want to add an ARN. We can go to our pool ARN by going to general settings, selecting this. We can paste it in right here. We can click on add, review the policy. This will be tutorial, add user attributes, create the policy. Now we want to go to roles. We're going to create a role that has all of those attributes inside of them. We're going to use this on Lambda. We're going to go to the permissions tutorial, and we can select the three policies we just created. We're not going to have any tags. We can click on review. We're going to call this the same exact thing as our Lambda function, which is create API key. Okay, so now that role has been created, we can close out of IAM. We can go to choose or create an execution role, use an existing role, and we can search for create API key, which we see right here. If you don't see it, try clicking refresh because we created the role after the Lambda function page has been loaded. We could then create the function. If we go into VS Code, we can copy the code that we wrote. We can paste it in the inline editor here. So we do Control S to save here. We save at the top right. And now we need to go back to our user pools. We need to select triggers. We want to scroll down to post confirmation. This is whenever the user actually confirms their account with their email address. The Lambda function, we want to search for create API key. If you don't see it, try refreshing. If we select create API key and click on save changes. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to look up my Cognito user and I'm going to delete it. And then I'm going to try signing up again. So we disable the user and then we delete the user. And now it's deleted. If we make sure our React app is running, which it is, and I refresh, we now see some exceptions, that's fine. And we're trying to use a sign up option. So I'll type in my email again. And I'll type in a password. And to make sure everything is easy to read, let's go over to API Gateway, and I want to delete all of the API keys that are associated with this. So now if I search tutorial under API keys, they're no longer there. If I go back to my React app, and I click on sign up, we see that everything should have worked correctly. I'm now gonna check my email. And when I clicked on my confirmation, we get this error here. So it says post confirmation failed, the error missing required key username in params. The reason for that is because we're actually using event.sub. However, that's actually not what we need to do. Event.request.userAttributes. Keep in mind this is a capital U and an uppercase A. If we save this, we can then copy the code and we can go over and paste it inside of Lambda. We can Control S and then click on save at the top right, and this should now work. Keep in mind that you will have to delete your Cognito user because you cannot resend a verification link at this time. This is something I'll cover in the future. And so here, if I try to create another account, we can click on sign up. It seems like it worked. I'll check my email. And then it says your registration has been confirmed. So if we go over and we refresh our users, we can then search by email. So this is going to be a brand new account. We see our custom API key is right here. We see that we do not have a custom plan because we have to manually set that within the React app. However, the custom API key was automatically set. So if I go to the React app and I try logging in, it then says logged in. If I refresh, we now see more options here. So everything seems to be working so far. If I try fetching a random number, we actually get a random number. And so it's working automatically. So the API key is correctly being set whenever the user is being created, and it is being attached correctly to the API gateway, which requires the API key. Thanks for watching this AWS tutorial. If you need help or have a video request, be sure to leave a comment down below or ask in the Warnoff Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description. If you want to learn more about AWS, consider clicking on one of the videos you see on your screen now.